Hey everyone, my name is Kajal and welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm in conversation with Vrinda Bansal, a young roboticist in the making. We talk about participating in robotics competition, specifically VEX Robotics, and how she's giving back to the community through her company, Think Fast Robotics. I'll include all of the timings and relevant resources in the description below. So without further ado, let's get into it. All right, let's get started. Hey, Vrinda, thank you for joining us. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself and your journey so far?
Yeah, hi, Kajal. Hello, my name is Vrinda Bansal. I'm a high school junior in the San Francisco Bay Area. Just a little bit about me. I was actually born in India, but then I moved to Canada and lived there for about 12 years and then moved here to the United States. Yeah, I know it's a lot. I can speak about four languages, English, Hindi, French, Python, print hello world. I'm currently involved at Reinvented Magazine, Artificial Intelligence Club at DB, P-Club, and I actually recently started Think Fast Robotics, which we'll go over a bit later. In my free time, I love to read up on the latest news, playing basketball, baking something, which is usually bread, or doing something with my hands, whether it be playing my guitar or sketching, maybe swimming.
Wow, you have such an interesting and varied background. And like you said, you stayed in so many places, picked up languages, including Python, which is really amazing. And I hope we all get to try your bread someday. With that, let's talk a little bit about robotics. How did you get started with robotics?
So my robotics journey actually starts all the way back in sixth grade in Canada. So my teacher decided to give us Google's 20% time project. If you're not familiar with it, basically it's where you spend 20% of your time on something that you feel passionate about. So in sixth grade, I decided to be really ambitious and I wanted to create a robot in which would help the elderly and anyone really mow the lawn, rake the leaves, and shovel up the snow. Living in Canada, that was a pain. So that's where it all started. Then my family moved here to the Bay Area and there were opportunities all around me. The summer going into high school, I decided to compete at a VEX girl-powered competition at Google. This was truly the turning point for me. I went into the competition knowing absolutely nothing about mechanical build or robotics programming or just anything about it in general. What I got coming out of it was a lot of experience and a newfound interest in robotics.
What an interesting journey all the way from sixth grade in Canada to Bay Area. I'm glad all of these places that you've been has contributed towards your journey. And as you rightly said, competitions are a great way to enter without knowing anything because there are these challenges that are designed for you to learn things. So with that, tell us a little bit more about what is VEX Robotics.
So if you search up a VEX Robotics competition, you'll be met with VEX Robotics is a robotics program for elementary through high school, through university students. But I'll give you a different definition, something that tells you a little bit more about it. VEX Robotics is a robotics program which runs two main leagues, VEX IQ and VEX EDR. I compete at the high school level in VEX EDR. The VEX programs have a team structure, meaning that teams compete in the competition. It's not just a one-person thing. This greatly improves your teamwork, and I believe that it gives you a lot more skills rather than just going in there alone. There are basically three levels of this competition, specifically VEX EDR and VEX IQ: local level, state level, and then world level. Basically, how it works is that you compete at local level. If you win at local level, you move on to state level, and so on and so forth.
Wow, that is really great to know. And as you said, you know, there are all these options that you have, and it's really amazing. Amazing that this competition exists for elementary, high school, and even university level competition. Now, based on our prior conversation, I know that you've competed at world level, and I believe you've participated in this competition for two, or this is your third year now, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So based on your experience so far, can you tell us what it is like being part of a team, competing? What are some of the challenges you faced, and what are the learnings you had?
So yeah, so I've been involved, as you said, in the VEX world for about 2.5 years now. This is my third year, and we're kind of in the middle of the season. My first year was with my school's team, and it was definitely an experience. It was the first time I experienced discrimination against girls in robotics. Being one of the only three freshmen to get into the school's robotics team, being a girl and a programmer at that, I kind of had the worst of the blows. But that's all right, because we won California State Championships and even competed at world level in Kentucky. My second year, I was faced with the same discouragement in my school. We qualified to state championships. However, we were not able to advance or attend because of COVID. Although I had these experiences, I also had amazing experiences being part of these teams. I'm extremely grateful for those 2 years because I gained so much knowledge on building techniques, programming techniques, and presentation techniques. And I met so many teams around California and around the world. So when it comes to being part of a VEX robotics team, I think that the VEX community as a whole is a very, it's a very nice community because you feel part of something that, you know, you're competing in, something that you're passionate about, and other people who are like you. Off of those experiences in my past 2 years, this year, I decided it was time for a change. So I created my own team and my own organization, which is completely female-led and only for girls, to compete at these same competitions, but in a fair and positive manner.
Yeah, well, I'm really sorry to hear that you had this sad experience of facing discrimination. And it is true. In the world of robotics, as well as other areas, being a woman is not accepted as easily as being a man who's able to code and work. And I'm really glad that you're turning that around and you still went through and continued to do and learn all of these things about robotics. So before we get into your work and Think Fast Robotics, I first wanted to ask you, how would someone go about starting their own team or, you know, starting participation in robotics competition like VEX Robotics?
I love that question, first off. I love that question because when I started off this team, if I had saw somebody answer these questions, I felt like it would be so much better. So the first thing is that I would say that first ask yourself if you're ready to dedicate yourself to the team. Are you willing to make a sacrifice for the team? Because at the beginning, if you're especially thinking about it, it's pretty scary. It's really scary and you're probably thinking that if I don't do well, people are going to laugh at me. What if this happens? What if that happens? So if you're able to answer those two questions, then I think that you're going to gain your confidence on your own. If you can answer those questions, you're going to know that you can do it and this is something you want to do. And so that is the main thing, is that gaining the confidence that that's what you can do and that you will win it. You will do it. The second thing I would tell is that you got to budget well. So we all know that the world's not perfect. And if you want to start a new team, you got to know where your funding is coming from. This means robotics parts. Especially for VEX, robotics parts and electronics are generally really costly. For my team, we resorted to crowdfunding, which we're really grateful for, and sponsorship. So that's just something that you should really have at the back of your head and something you should just know. Final thing is that the recruitment of people, it's probably a question that goes in your head, especially if you want to do a VEX team, is that you got to be ready to teach new but dedicated people. There's a lot of people out there, especially girls, who are really interested in it. They really want to know how to do it, but they don't know how. So you have to be ready to teach them. And trust me, the output is amazing. So the best way to recruit people is to reach out in your community, in your school, try talking to your friends, try asking your friends to ask their friends, try talking to leaders around you and people who can just help you spread the word.
Yeah, that's a great answer. And like you said, the first part is being prepared yourself. You know, it's going to be a tough challenge, but if you believe in yourself, you can get that confidence and do anything you want. And I know you mentioned that one of the biggest challenges is teaching people to do things because there are people who are excited and passionate about this and they just don't know how. And that's where your company fit right in. So tell us about your company and how you're helping girls all around the world participate in robotics competition to learn and just get started.
Yeah. So just a little bit about my organization, Think Fast Robotics. Think Fast Robotics is a female-led organization geared towards girls and non-binary individuals in all high schools in California. Our mission is to create a safe, inclusive environment to practice robotics. And we've established a VEX Robotics team, 2772J, wearing their hoodie today. So when it comes to just the organization, you know, as I mentioned before, it's really towards just being passionate in robotics. And then if we're passionate, we can do all sorts of things. To help younger kids, like you said, how can we get other people excited? We actually run an apprenticeship program. Although we're a high school team, we realize how important it is to engage our youth and give them exposure and confidence that this is an option for them at a younger age. This is where our apprenticeship program kicks in. Think Fast Robotics apprenticeship program is for incoming middle schoolers and high schoolers who are, or maybe elementary schoolers, depending on your passionate level, who are interested in robotics, but don't know if this is their passion yet. This is a really key point because if you know about robotics and people around you are like, hey, don't touch that screwdriver, you're going to hurt yourself. How are you going to explore it? So apprenticeship program is completely cost-free, completely commitment-free. It's just to know if that's something you want to do. Today, we have 10 apprentices worldwide in places like South Africa. So if you're interested, you can totally look for them.
Yeah, and I'll include the link in the description. Do check it out. And like you said, it's an opportunity for you to explore that is robotics for you. Are you passionate? And then get started and go wherever you want to go with that. Mm-hmm. So with this 2 years of robotics competition and starting your own company, what is the one big lesson that you have learned? And what is the one advice you would give to someone who's just starting out?
So the biggest thing that I learned was it's important to believe in yourself and the power of that. Yeah, it's the biggest learning because if you don't believe in yourself, then nobody will. And also just have people around you who believe in you, because if other people around you believe in you, it also gives you confidence. So for me, that was my my mom and dad. The amount of times my dad had to tell me, oh, don't worry about that. Just go ahead and do it. That really gave me confidence. So I think that's the biggest learning. That's also the biggest tip that I would give, is that find people around you who will support you and not hurt you. And if not, then you always have yourself.
Yeah, that is great advice. You know, surround yourself by people who will support you, especially when you yourself will doubt you. You know, people who will be like, hey, the point of this is to try and have fun. So just go for it. Don't worry so much about failing. Once again, thank you so much for joining us, Vrinda, today. And I wish you all the best for your team for this upcoming year, as well as for Think Fast Robotics. And I'll include all of the links in the description. So do check out the apprenticeship program if you want to explore robotics.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.